If you don't think the White House knows exactly who left the cocaine in the West Wing, I feel bad for you. Yeah, guys, they just don't know who it is. If this had happened when Donnie was in office, this would be on the front page of every newspaper on the planet and would lead absolutely every news broadcast, likely for a year afterwards. The boundary of the White House is monitored by infrared cameras that can detect the slightest change in temperature. It sits at the center of a 15-mile restricted flight zone, equipped with surface-to-air missiles and roof-mounted radar. The White House has a team of snipers that must accurately hit a target 1,000 yards away every month to qualify. The White House has a bunker that can withstand a nuclear attack. A lethal dose of fentanyl is smaller than a pencil tip and kills more than 60,000 people in the United States a year. It is a white powder with seemingly no visual discernible difference from what they likely found. Yet you mean to tell me that in the most secure building on the planet, that a bag of nose beers was left there a day after Hunter was there and they really don't know whose it is? The contents of this baggie could have quite easily taken out the President of the United States, which isn't saying much because the guy's built like a dandelion spore. If you sneeze, he'd disappear into the breeze. But they're like, we don't know whose it is. All right. Oh, if you actually believe that, you're dumb as fuck.